Mullet, and he will be doing, he's the lead for his group.
Alright, good afternoon. My name's Steve Mullet. I'm the group lead for group three, and this is me, 4611, section 5. I'm going to talk about the ranking cycle experiment we're going to do next week for some of us. And to start out, you can see the basic TS diagram of a ranking cycle. And I'll get into that in more detail later. Quick overview. What I'm going to talk about today. First, I'm going to go over a little background, kind of what you need to know about the ranking cycle and all that. Then I'm going to show you the apparatus of the actual experiment, which is in the back. And then a little bit of the theory and the objectives, and then I'm going to throw in little projections from doing the experiment. Essentially pull out your energy from your steam, which I forgot to say, after it leaves the boiler, it could either be like superheated steam, or it can just be saturated vapor. It just depends how you set your cycle. So when it goes to the turbine blades take out energy, and the steam actually spins the blades, causing the shaft to rotate, and then take that out. Take that rotation, hook it up to a electrical generator, and create electricity from it. It's kind of how you're basically how we get power today still. And then finally, once it leaves the turbine, you take as much power out as you can, energy out of it as you can, and then condense it to get it back to a liquid so we can pump it. And that's pretty much the basics. Here's a set of our apparatus. Some of the specific things, pieces of equipment we have in this experiment. First is a single stage Copas RL12L turbine. That's for getting energy out of steam. We also have a ProEquip 316SS plate. Counterflow heat exchanger, where I think that's part of the condenser. Yeah. And then we're going to use the university boiler for this experiment. They have a boiler back there, I think, but for the experiment, we're going to use the university steam, which is created off of that. And then you can see our setup bar here. We have the pump, which comes from the feed water tank. This is the boiler. Turbine, and you have your workout generator, and then your condenser, and then doing it all over again. And then we have safety across the valves and traps and all that too. And then also the university boiler and the system before we use it. Some of the theory and objectives. So some of the equation we're using, pump work, which is equal to difference in your pressures times your mass flow rate times your specific volume. And then also your boiler you heat in, that's going to be your change in your entropy. And then that's times your mass flow rate, and that'll give you how much heat you're actually gaining. And then the condenser, same thing, except for you're not doing it from between the pump and the, going into the turbine, you're doing it from the turbine to the pump. And then finally, you're looking at efficiencies, which is our big thing. The total efficiency, we're going to look at the one that says H1, and that's H1 minus Q out minus Q in, or basically your boiler heat, or your condenser heat out and your boiler heat in, over your boiler heat in. And then the turbine efficiency, which is the total efficiency, it's your H2 minus your H3 actual, which is what you actually get versus the theoretical. Isentropic process. And then some of the objectives we want to do, we want to find the efficiency, big ones, we want to find the efficiency of the turbine, and we want to find the efficiency of the cycle. And we also want to know what some of the stuff to do, like steam somewhere, steam trapping, several other pieces of equipment. Okay, for our objectives, past results said they had a P1 of about 100 psi gauge. Atmosphere. And then the point saturated vapor at the boiler exit and then saturated liquid at the condenser exit. Using those numbers, I got our H's here. And then that gave us a thermal efficiency of 14.85, which is kind of low. And I think that's it. Yeah. Anybody have any questions?
So you talked about boilers, right? So
yeah.
What type of boiler are we using?
I wasn't sure. I know it was the university one. I'm not sure what we had back here. I didn't see that in the lab manual.
So, what do you think? It's a bi-tube, water tube, mixed tube?
In the university, they're probably using a bi-tube, I think, yes. I could tell you though. Any other questions? Thank you.